My name is Dr. Joyce Laboso. I am the Deputy Speaker of the National Assembly of Kenya. I'm a second term Member of Parliament. I represent a constituency in the Rift Valley. I'm really excited to be in this conference, particularly because we are talking about all the gains that women have made. You know, each year we reevaluate where we are in terms of women's empowerment. If I look at the Kenyan situation, I think a lot has been achieved, particularly through the new constitution, where affirmative action was embedded in the constitution. And as a result, we moved from being 22 members of parliament to currently 68 members of parliament. So really, it has been as a result of the affirmative action. That we have right now is that under the new constitution we have county governments, 47 county governments. Unfortunately, we have been unable to, we were unable in the last election to get even a single governor elected out of the 47. Neither were we able to get a single senator. All because some of them were sending out the message that the women had a reserved special seat. Therefore, there was no need of them being in the governor's, you know, participating or competing in the governor's or the senator's seat. So in a way, again, sometimes there is the downside of affirmative action. Continue the conversation, we have to continue the sensitization that investing in women, electing women, would be able to allow less women to be nominated or even the need for affirmative action. That if they were, once the society realizes that it makes economical sense, it makes social sense for one to elect women, then we'll be able to get less of women needing to be affirmed through affirmative action seats or even needing to go through a nomination sheets, which, as we are seeing, increases the wage bill in a country which sometimes is not possible. It's not helping the country to move forward.